They say that opposites eventually meet at the extremes, and I think that this is very, very well illustrated in where we've arrived in the last couple of videos that I've made and the discussions that have ensued. A couple of years ago, I was discussing Peter Weasel Zapffe. Zapffe, I guess, is what we call him in the Anglosphere here. In his Last Messiah, he implies that seeing the truth, seeing the universe in all its nakedness and its all its reality is enough to overwhelm the human mind, the human spirit, whatever you want to call it, and kill the human being. Clarity kills, according to Zapffe and the Last Messiah. The primordial human suddenly sees what he's stuck in, this universe thing, and it's more than he can handle. He dies. So he creates, or humanity creates, things, anchoring, sublimation, etc., etc. We're talking about anchoring, I suppose. Archimedes, give me a place to stand. Zapffe says that we have created this place to stand artificially in order to make sense out of a universe that really doesn't have any sense in it. That reality is horrifying, and that the only thing we can do is to distract ourselves from it by artificially and completely arbitrarily creating a place to stand. Now, it's interesting that Zapffe's anchor is used as a reason to deny life, whereas I'm sort of saying there's nothing wrong with creating anchors, provided we understand that that's what we do when we sort of create things like logical axioms. We're just anchoring. But I'm not trying to deny life in any way at all. As a matter of fact, from my own perspective, I'm triumphantly a life affirmer. That's my perspective, though. That's not anyone else's, and it doesn't need to be. It doesn't matter to me if I'm the only life affirmer in the universe. It's simply a perspective that I've taken. Zapffe says the ineffability of existence is enough to deny life, or deny life of its utility. Whereas we've, in the present discussion, when we're talking about axioms and places to stand, the place to stand is used to deny life. Zapffe is saying that we create an anchor, we drop our anchor in order to affirm life. Artificially affirm life, falsely affirm life. Whereas I get the impression that logic rolls the dice is saying that the anchor is real, and that's a reason to deny life. Don't let me strawman you, logic rolls the dice. If I've got you wrong, let me know. So we have two sort of interesting views of anchoring, or fixed points, or Archimedes' place to stand. One of them is an assertion by Zapffe that the place to stand is completely artificial and phony, and it's a calculated self-deception, and thus we must deny life. Logic rolls the dice says that that anchor is a fixed point, it is actually real, it is actually a good place to stand, thus we must deny life. Two places to stand, two radically different conclusions. Well, I suppose you have to back up a bit and sort of, at this point, ask yourself, what happens if we see reality? Zapffe says it will overwhelm you and kill you. And thus, it's best not to create other beings in this reality, because reality is just dreadful. Thomas Ligotti seems to say the same thing. H.P. Lovecraft seems to say the same thing. Fiction writers, but the points that they raise are philosophical and that sort of thing. Well, there are other views of what happens when you see reality. Zapffe and logic rolls the dice, I guess, aren't the only ones. In Plato's Allegory of the Cave, one of the prisoners is dragged up, and or it's sort of assumed or posited that what would happen if someone is dragged up out of the cave and forced to see the light of day and the sun and everything. It's implied that, or it's said, I guess, that the prisoner might go insane by seeing reality beyond the cave. But it's not guaranteed that he'll go insane. They just sort of said it would be probably so overwhelming that he wouldn't be prepared for it, whatever his reaction is. So in Plato's allegory of the cave, we're told that reality is just a massive shock. It might be a good shock and it might be a bad shock, but regardless, it's going to be a shock. The Bhagavad Gita, with its universal vision, Krishna says to Arjuna, you want to see reality? Okay, first I have to give you a certain divine pair of eyes in order to see reality. You're in for one heck of a shock here, so prepare yourself in as much as you can be. So he zaps Arjuna, and Arjuna sees reality and is, of course, overwhelmed by it, but he's not killed by it, and he's not driven insane. He just says, this is a bit much, to say the very least. But he can only take so much of it, and Krishna sort of removes his godlike seeing powers and restores normal human sight, and he says, whew, boy, that was quite a ride. I'm not quite sure I want to go through that again, but I'm not quite sure that I regret having done so. There's another view of the universal cosmic vision of everything. Zapffe baldly asserts that it would kill you no matter what, and that we create everything else to distract us from it. Plato says maybe it would kill you, maybe it wouldn't, but it would be radically different from what you're used to. Krishna in the Gita seems to imply that if you prepare yourself, you can handle it. But right now, as an unprepared human being, you can't. But here's the universal vision. It shocks you now, but if you engage in rigorous self-discipline, self-preparation, you will eventually be able to see the universal vision without being overwhelmed by it. In fact, you may actually like what you see. The very same thing, it's just you will have changed, your tools to cope will have been strengthened, and then you can deal with it. that's yoga. You prepare yourself for the universal. Another one, I suppose, which is implied, is Nietzsche. I don't know if it's his Übermensch or whatever, but the general thrust of his philosophy is, kick away all those props. You don't want the darn things anyway. Just become what you are. That's enough. You're just an animal. Why do you worry about things like concepts and abstractions and everything? Just become what you are. That's enough. You don't even need things like that. In fact, they're harmful to you. Just become nothing more than, say, a bear or a monkey or something like that. And now that's only one of myriad ways to read Nietzsche, but that is kind of implied in a lot of what I get out of what he has to say. Why get worked up about being something that you're not? Just be what you are. That, you know, reading between the lines, that would say that Nietzsche seems to say that Zapffe's panic is not a panic at all. In fact, if we did see things clearly without Zapffe's presuppositions as to things like guilt, because if you ask me, Zapffe's caveman is killed by guilt. He's not killed by anything else. He's killed by guilt. It's just, that's implied in the Last Messiah, whereas Nietzsche says, guilt is just in here. You've invented it. Why should you allow that to kill you? There's other things, other constructions that we've created, or sentiment, all this kind of thing, that are, again, artificial creations that have turned on us. I'm saying the same thing, I guess, about logic. I'm not saying that there's anything wrong with logic, but it has to be kept on a leash or it will turn on you and possibly kill you. So we're full circle. Some people say that reality is too much to be born and the best thing to do is to zap yourself out of existence. Interesting turn of phrase there. I didn't mean to say it that way, but zap yourself out of existence. or else reality will overwhelm you and kill you. The place to stand is lethal. or you get Nietzsche, who says all that's just crap, and your own constructions are what are killing you. As I say, Zapffe's caveman seemed to feel this enormous compassion and empathy for the entire cosmos, and that was simply too much for him in view of the fact that he was a hunter who had to kill in order to eat. What is reality? What is the fixed place to stand? What's its nature? Is the bedrock of our philosophy, i.e. Archimedes' place to stand, is that just Zapffe's anchor? Or is it reality itself? Or even if it does exist as a reality or as a non-reality, an artificial one, what's its ultimate nature? What is the place to stand? Is it good or is it bad? Zapffe says it's not even there. Logic rolls the dice, says it's absolute. Both of them are life deniers. Again, don't let me pigeonhole you. If I'm wrong, correct me. Zapffe says, there is no fixed place to stand, so we create one. And we shouldn't have babies. Logic rolls the dice, says, there is a fixed place to stand. We don't create it. It exists outside of us. Therefore, we should not have babies. I'd like to apply anekantavada to that one. That would be interesting. And that's kind of what I asked way back when I sort of set the ball rolling with Forever Wolf Films. I just asked, is there any way to reconcile these two? Looks like we're getting close.